ओके, लेट मी जस्ट शेयर माय स्क्रीन। सो इज दिस स्क्रीन विजिबल एंड एम आई ऑडिबल बोथ? Okay, visible and audible both. Thank you so much. So let's begin. Temporarily unmuting, muting all of you. Then I'll unmute you just as I begin. So friends, welcome to this Zoom session. Originally scheduled for Sunday only. The finance session, the money lessons from the pandemic. Of course, I've given you a theoretical part. There were a few takeaways. This will be slightly more extensive than that, covering almost all the takeaways. And again, not going to take more than 45 to 60 minutes, hopefully, unless I stop at one point to discuss anything in depth. So again, as usual, all my presentations will always begin with thanking the Lord Almighty, who's given me much more than what I deserve. But when it comes to finance, I have to thank my dad as well, who's instrumental in teaching me the clinical finance, the one we manage in our clinic. Of course, my MBA finance also comes handy. But what he has taught, it can be taught by no one to me, of course. No CA knows that much in depth as my dad did. At least the ones I've come in, connection with. So this is my brief bio data as usual at the start. So you all are aware of it. This is session number 18, Finance Money Lessons Learned from the Pandemic. This will be taken up in today's topic. So let's begin. So again, the first slide is the same as the previous session. The only change are a few words. We all said Happy New Year on 31st December 2020 or 2019. And we are very skeptical of saying the same in 4 days' time from now. We don't know what kind of year 2021 would turn out to be because the fear of end of the pandemic hasn't gone fully out of the equation yet. But yes, we all began our year cheerfully, hoping that it'll be the best of the decade. Of course, the new decade had supposedly begun, but then it caught us off guard just before the end of the first quarter. And by March, things became from happy to worse to worst. So we didn't anticipate what could happen, but then it did. The COVID-19, the coronavirus disease 2019, actually came into existence, and it was a reality in today's, it is a reality in today's world. So 2020 is the year of pandemic attributed to COVID-19. The end of the year is just around the corner, but it has been a wonderful, not in that sense, but an eventful year. Wonderful year in the sense of scientific discoveries. Yes, a new vaccine was discovered. So many companies working behind it. But then as the Greek philosopher Heraclitus has wrote wonderfully, the only thing constant in life is change. And we need to accept the change, whether we like it or not. And we need to move on in life. And not only the lives, of course, the economy was dealt a severe blow multiple times, and many of the changes happened irreversibly as well. For the first time ever in my life, I am 44, in my life of 44 years, I saw the oil, crude oil, go to minus 37. Never would anybody thought that it will go even to zero, just because there was no demand and there was no storage space. Imagine oil going in the negative zone. Then as we dealt in the previous session of practice management, we have to learn from the experience. Disaster presents an opportunity. Aapda may be avsar dhoonde. So the importance is that we need to be financially prepared because there are many things. Even the people who had strictly locked themselves in the lockdown and even beyond what the government told them to do, they also came out just in the pursuit of one thing, money, because that is the one thing that keeps the world running, or the, as you say, the mayor running, or the horse running. So how has this been 2020? Good for some, bad for some, worse for some, worst for some, disaster for many. So it is a painful year for some, but it has actually changed the whole landscape of financial equation in the world, and particularly India. And what are the lessons, what are the carry-home lessons? So I'll be straight away coming to the point, rather than as in the practice management session, we discuss the details and then the medical point and then the dental point. So in this session, I'll be directly coming to the financial lessons to be derived, what it is. So the only reality was that we actually would believe that anything can happen in 1 month, in a, even a moment's notice. And so many things to learn in life about resilience, community, humanity. So just have a retrospective look and look back what financial lessons, of course, those lessons, again, those things are nothing new to us, but that actually reinforced our faith in the point that financial things need to be taken carefully, irrespective of what your profession is. You might be a dentist, you might be, say, banker, you might be a doctor, you might be architect, you might be a lawyer, policeman, but if you are not financially sound, nothing will work, because everything runs on money. People can't buy things with love. Of course, to keep the stove burning, you need to have finance in hand. Of course, I'm not going to that philosophical nature, what love can buy and what finance can, what money can buy, but just to tell you that many things, or rather most of the things, run by money only. And many of the uncertainties happened in politics, especially in the US elections, although it was expected, the kind of fight which went on till the last moment between Joe Biden and Donald Trump was unexpected. Then environmental changes, so many cyclones, Amphan, and so many changes happening on the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea border. Then economical changes happened, the market crashing 40% and then going in less than 9 months to an all-time high currently as well. So there are so many changes. Nobody can say what is the, say, what is going to happen the next moment. Yes, the moment the market went up last Friday, Monday, the news of a new strain from UK crashed the market to 1500 points. But then in the next 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, Friday was a holiday for Christmas. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, it recovered 432, 302, and about 529 points to roughly bear off the losses which it had gotten on the dreadful Monday morning. Like the Monday blues we all have. So it is, if not wonderful or eventful, it is at least an extraordinary year, 2020. It has actually shown us the reverse side of life, the flip side. And the biggest carry-home message, apart from everything else, is to value our lives. So my finance lessons will begin from there only. What all have you learned from this or learned in this? Health insurance is not an unnecessary expense. People used to believe that health insurance is not needed, because most of the things are not covered in that. The only thing is, we need to realize that these things can burn a big hole in the pocket if we are not insured. And people really didn't take say insurance very seriously, especially those who were having a group insurance from their employers. They never realized that, let's suppose if they're working for 20 years, but if they're laid off, as happened in many companies, if they were laid off from their jobs, they'll actually lose their insurance as well. So if they have been working from 24 to 44, up to my age approximately, so what would that mean? That would mean that they'll have to buy an expensive insurance plan. And once you lose a job, your insurance goes away. So you need to have a separate cover as well. When we discussed insurance in one of the sessions, I told you in detail about those things. Of course, that your video is on YouTube as well. You can watch for those details. Of course, not going into depth, I'm just covering the mistakes part here. So don't only depend on your employer's insurance, especially for the salaried, but for the same self-employed, you all need to have an insurance. Unless you have money to burn, unless you have, say, money spare with you, unless you can, say, devote money, don't go in that part. Because even the COVID bills have gone up to 16, 17 lakhs for a few people that have been reported in the initial phase of COVID. So what does that mean? A normal medical insurance is expected to be in the range of 4 to 5 lakhs. So for a COVID, then that would be enough. So a family floater plan, 10-15 lakh, or a separate COVID plan, which roughly say costs you just about 1%. 50,000 policy would cost you roughly in the range of 450 rupees. So that is just 1% only. So you need to understand what kind of cover you take, inclusive in your policy or a separate COVID cover. I would recommend a separate COVID cover apart from your medical insurance otherwise. So don't treat it as an unnecessary expense. It is not a product that you will actually rue buying otherwise. So right health insurance will actually take care of expenses as well. So, and separate insurance other than your employer's policy will tide over the uncertainties in your life, which we currently are having as well. So, the second lesson from this pandemic is life insurance. We actually have been confusing life insurance with our endowment plan. Many people actually don't know that endowment plans are actually money back plans. And term plan needs to be like a vehicle insurance. You at the most would get NCB, no claim bonus. But otherwise, if you say live for another year, you'll have to pay the insurance again. It is like a vehicle insurance, and that is called as the term plan. That is actually the life insurance, and that is available for lesser amount. For a young non-smoker male of 28, 29, a 1 crore cover would cost roughly around 6,000 rupees. Akshay Kumar, Pankaj Tripathi, बेचारे चीख चीख के दुखी हो गए 2 साल से कि टर्म प्लान ले लो, टर्म प्लान ले लो. दैट इज द रीजन द कोविड एक्चुअली रीइग्नाइटेड फेथ इन दोज प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस. एंड ऑल द डेटा इज अवेलेबल ऑल ओवर द नेट. यू कैन सर्च फॉर द पॉलिसी यू वांट, यू कैन सर्च फॉर द राइडर्स, यू कैन सर्च फॉर द मिनिमम अमाउंट कवर्ड, यू कैन गो अबाउट ऑल दोज टास्क, कवर ऑल द राइडर्स, गेट अ कोटेशन. सो मेनी थर्ड पार्टीज आर अवेलेबल दैट कैन हेल्प यू एज सच. सो इट इज अ ट्रेजेडी दैट something of this magnitude, where the world lost a great deal of its population, of course, not in numbers, but in, say, social life structure, that we needed to understand this thing. People actually, some people think that if the only thing they ask their insurance advisor is, agar main bach gaya toh, what will I get? As I said, you have a vehicle insurance. Of course, if there was no law for it, of having an insurance for a vehicle, nobody would have bought that either. But yes, if you have a big luxury car and you have insurance for that, would you want that? Would you want to get hit? You would always want that you don't have to claim that, say, insurance any year because you love your car. Similarly, we have to love our life as well. So invest in a term plan for your life cover. Those endowment plans which offer say, risk cover as well or a insurance cover as well, they are a portion of that. They may be used as a portion, but not as a whole life cover. It is always advisable to keep insurance and investment separately. Money back plans are investments. Term plans are life insurance. So insurance and investment should always be separate. Because once a term plan elapses after 1 year, you don't have say you don't get anything on maturity except the NCB, and that only in limited policies. So the endowment plan may otherwise be good for your short-term goals, but for term your life cover, these low-cost policies are the best way to take insurance cover. So lesson number three, which I have been speaking even pre-COVID since the past 3-4 years, keep an emergency fund. It depends upon individual to individual. For a normal middle class family, which most of us are, this cover should be from 2 to 6, 2 to 7 lakhs, depending upon your say social economic condition or whatever you can afford. The only reason is the blind formula behind this is, first of all, is to have 3 months gross income or 6 months expenses. If you don't have that, you need to realize that you are actually, say, faltering on some point. See, there were a lot of job cuts around supposedly 40% of people all over the world lost their jobs. Yes, some got reemployed, but that was the initial knee-jerk reaction, if I may say so, to COVID. And those who didn't lose their job, they were rather expecting a raise in March, April, or April, May. They rather got a cut in their salary, 60% cut of 40% or a 20% or a 30%, anything from they were getting from anything from 62% from the original. Imagine they were expecting a 100 plus 10 or a 15% raise, and they were getting around 60. So effectively around half of what they were expecting, close to half. So these kind of, the only thing is this, these things create a problem when you have a large EMI looming over your head. And you have made investments, keeping in mind, or say bought assets, keeping this thing in mind. Itna to hum kam se hum kama hi lenge, to itna to EMI de hi denge. That is the thing you need to realize, that those things in these times, emergency fund would come really handy. Luckily, RBI announced a moratorium, which did provide temporary relief to many of the, people have opted for the loans. But then, the big lesson was for everyone else to maintain an emergency fund so that the EMI does not get a skip over there. So unforeseen events can say upset anyone, anyone's life, anyone's financial condition. You need to realize that. So make sure that emergency fund is stashed separately, either in a liquid fund or a bank deposit. Bank deposit here does not mean a bank fixed deposit. It can be a free fund in the high earning savings bank account like IDFC bank. At this point, again, want to make it clear, I've said it so many times, all RBI regulated banks are safe. There is no difference in private or government when it comes to RBI regulated banks. It is for people with old thinking, orthodox mentality, who still think that the Sarkari bank is safe. They might be wrong. Rather, the government banks have been merged. The private banks are still alive in that sense. Yes Bank had a fiasco on 5th of March. It was my brother's birthday on that. We were having family dinner just before COVID. And suddenly came the news that RCA, that Yes Bank had doomed. The only thing we need to understand, who was the savior? It was a 1 month or a 28-day moratorium till the 3rd of April. But 16th March, 11 days after that fiasco, the moratorium was lifted. The biggest investor, State Bank of India, with 49% investment in the Yes Bank. It is for you to believe or think whatever you want to, but RBI regulated banks all are safe in that matter. You just saw a Bank of Singapore, DBS Bank, overtaking a LVB, Lakshmi Vilas Bank, just a month back. What would a Singapore bank? Yes, it has got an Indian license, but if that bank has got and has, say, overtaken LVB, so there is no difference in that sense. Yes, at that point, this point of time, again, want to make a difference between the point that cooperative banks are not exactly banks. They are not RBI regulated. They are cooperative societies who call themselves as banks. Unless they are RBI regulated, they are not safe at all. And trust me, banks हम लोग गिनते ना कितने 20 21 22 अब कम रह गए हैं प्राइवेट गिन के शायद अराउंड 20 25 banks maximum in the all over India, but there are 1573 cooperative societies which are doomed as bank. Recently there was a provision by the government that cooperative banks would also be RBI regulated. So if that happens, then it's fine, but otherwise don't distinguish between a private and a government bank, but do distinguish between a cooperative and a RBI regulated bank. I don't consider a private government when it comes to comparison. I consider only RBI regulated and a cooperative society. So as I said, the rule of thumb is to have at least 6 months of expenses or 3 months of gross income. It is one and the same thing if you take 50% as your expenses. So it means you need to be prepared for such kind of fiasco. We say save the money for the rainy days, and the rainy days arrived as early as the first quarter of this year. Trust me, 3 weeks into the first lockdown, 16th of April, 15th of April, when there was that was the time the lockdown was there. People would actually say running helter skelter. They were worried, where will the cash come from? Where will they have money flowing in for the clinic? Imagine if somebody doesn't have even a month's income at disposal, what do you expect? And then stock market crashed, everyone panicked, people sold off their assets, booked losses. 9 months down the line, things are much better. I mentioned in the last session, GST collections were all-time high last quarter. 1 lakh crore, not a small amount. Something has been sold, that is only the GST has been booked. whether it is online or physical, that is a different story altogether. That is not, the government has got the revenue. The stock market is at all-time high. Nobody now cribs. People will still say, abhi manda chal raha hai, patient nahi hai, all those things. People will continue to say that. I have a friend who keeps saying this. He started practice almost with me. He's changed 5 clinics. He's now built a dream clinic in say 150 square foot area. 1,500 square foot area. So 1,500. And got a Fortuner, got I think one more luxury car. And still he says, main to bahut gareeb hoon, main bahut, mere paas patient hi nahi hai. If we continue to do that, it is a individual choice. That depends on nature. But if you say that the dentistry is doomed as a profession, I seriously beg to disagree in that regard. So you need to think about the emergency fund very strongly. Because you never know. I don't wish and hope, but you never know. You should be prepared for all eventualities in life. So then don't get unnerved by volatility. People actually reacted to 40% fall. Stock market went close to 24,000-25,000 from close to 38,000-39,000 or 40,000. It went to 24,000-25,000 approximately. So actually people panicked and booked losses. Those who did not actually have earned handsome amount over there. And even the benchmark indices have been crossed big time. So all those things will keep on happening. Political, economic, social instability will continue to happen all over the world. And that is going to impact. But the only thing is, if you have invested for a long term, do not get, say unperturbed by these volatilities. As I said, we are at all-time high levels in December. Those who actually, say, exited in March, they converted their temporary loss into permanent ones. I always say with the FII, the foreign institution investing at its all-time high, 20 lakh crores is the investment of FII currently. The local contribution is less. This is beyond 15th March. I always said in my workshop also recently, this is the time to book your profits if you have been holding your things. Yes, if you want to, I'm not saying that the market will crash in future, but yes, there are certain things, certain times we, हम बोलते हैं ना कि ये टाइम आएगा तो मैं ये चीज निकालूंगा. मे बी फॉर अ पर्पस यू नीड अ फंड 6 मंथ्स डाउन द लाइन. दैट गोल इज 6 मंथ्स अवे, बट यू ऑलरेडी क्रॉस दैट. सो बुक दैट प्रॉफिट टुडे. यू नेवर नो, इन नेक्स्ट 6 मंथ्स टाइम यू मे नॉट बी गेटिंग द सेम अमाउंट व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग टुडे. देन यू विल रू ओवर द फैक्ट. सो देयर इज नो परफेक्ट टाइम. यू कांट एक्चुअली टाइम द मार्केट, बट रिमेंबर यू हैव टू ड्रॉ अ लाइन व्हेन यू वांट द मनी एंड व्हेन यू डोंट. इट इज good to be patient with the investment part, but unless you have a knowledge of a stock market, don't jump into this jungle. And stock market, wo Harshad Mehta ki scam story aayi na Sony Lip pe, that stock market ek gehra kuwa hai jo sare India ki pyaas bujha sakta hai, aur main is kuwe mein dubki lagana chahta hu. Don't do that. Yes, it is a good way to earn money, but only if you have a good knowledge. Don't invest on hearsay is my best advice to you for this evening. So if you are not sure, the best way to grow silently is via the SIP route. So people who have actually, say, have been doing SIP very diligently, they are earning amount over a certain period of time. Trust me, I've been taking these sessions of mutual funds in my WhatsApp groups, and many people called up or messaged me in the month of April. सर आपके कहने पे म्यूचुअल फंड में पैसे लगाए थे, व्हाट हैपेंड, हमारे तो पैसे डूब गए, ऑल माय प्राइसेस आर इन रेड. सो मेनी पीपल कंप्लेन टू मी. आई जस्ट टोल्ड देम टू कीप पेशेंस. ट्रस्ट मी, नाउ द मार्केट इज एट ऑल टाइम हाई. इवन आई एम से ट्रैकिंग डाउन द म्यूचुअल फंड्स. आई हैव आल्सो बुक्ड प्रॉफिट फॉर अ फ्यू ऑफ माय फंड्स, बट नॉट अ सिंगल पर्सन कॉल्ड मी टू कॉम्प्लीमेंट कि हाँ अब हमारा पैसा ग्रो कर गया. शिकायत सबने की. सो दिस इज द वे द वर्ल्ड गोज. You always criticize first, you always compliment later. Never mind, I don't mind that. But what I mean to understand, make you understand, is that if you are not very sure, do not jump into this jungle. The lesson number 5 I mentioned in the theoretical session as well, rebalance your portfolio. When the market is volatile, you can rebalance by decreasing your, say, equity portion. And it actually restores the original asset allocation. When you actually reallocate, you, say, rebalance a particular asset class. And it was a good sign in March when it was 40% down. So you who actually followed this rule, and only one person messaged me, sir, I followed this thing. He's my paid group member as well. So he said, I made a lot of money, courtesy your advice, and I'm thankful to you. So he attended my workshop last year. So always remember that ups and downs will be a part of life. The only thing you need to, if you need to grow your money in stock market, you need to keep patience. So focus on needs, not on wants. COVID actually stripped us naked in this regard. We were actually lying that kitni cheezon ke bina hamara nahi chalta. COVID, at least the initial 6 weeks or one and a half month, showed us that we actually needed not much things for our survival in life. Especially when we had pay cuts, those who were salaried and those who were, say, self-employed, had clinics and were not going to practice, they actually didn't have any income. So, but they actually saw that their cost of living was not much if their wants were eliminated from their life. And that is what a perfect shock to any individual would have been there. So we need to realize that needs are more important, but wants are not. So households, those who didn't face any income loss, also need to avoid unnecessary expenses. Because if you throw wants, you can fit all your needs at once. What are all wants? Going for a vacation, just based on the four, say, FOMO approach, fear of missing out, buying a luxury car, buying a house, buying something, going to a, say, overtly expensive restaurant for eating. It's fine once in a while, but just to copy someone because someone has put up a status or a story on Facebook or social media so that you want to copy him or her. So that is actually a bad sign. I always say, rather than a FOMO approach in this, have a JOMO approach. The joy of missing out. And there are some things in life which actually need to be understood very clearly in that regard. So saving money can make you financially independent, providing you with security in face of emergencies. And unnecessary expenditure should always be cut off. And it always means living below your means, as it is like, if you live below your means, it is like eating a lot, eating healthy. You know, you'll have to give up a few things, but it is going to be hard as well. But it ultimately be beneficial for your body as well. So you can find a balance of enjoying life if you follow a financial plan. Essential expenses, your bills, repayments, debts, loans, all should be spared first. And those are actually in your needs part. Saving of future is again a perfect need. Then you can spend if you're left over the money. As they say, save mindlessly, spend consciously. We do the reverse, the Warren Buffett statement. We actually spend mindlessly and save consciously. You need to understand that. So we just need to give up a few luxuries of life and save for the big ticket items. I always mention my, say, wealth creation seminars. It is indeed sorrowful to ask for money from your kids in your old age. Even if you are, say, employed in college, you will not get any pension. So you need to build up your retirement fund yourself. Nobody is going to give you a gratuity or a pension in your old life, at least not for the even the private colleges as well. The peace of mind is very important. And along with that, it is important to have a budget. If you have a budget, you limit your expenses, especially your debt or your loan and your needs. I've given you the formula in many of my YouTube videos. You can go. The standard is the 50-30-20 formula. I've given an alter magical 50 formula by the name, going by my name, the 45-15-40 formula. Not going to go into the details, but there are so many videos on the same topic for the budgeting part in depth on that. So if you're having a budget, you can actually easily adjust your budget to suit your new income because you know where you are going to say spend upon in those regards. Then lesson number 7, don't plan on the basis of future income. Again, itna to hum kamai lenge approach is to be, say, remembered very clear. So the loss of income was a big lesson for everyone, even an investor or a consumer. We actually bought so many things and based on the fact that itna aayega to usse EMI de denge. So people actually finalized so many things for, say, big homes, vehicles, and other things which they were planning. But considering that 2020 is going to be the best year, their astrologer also confirmed it many a times. But then who knew that COVID-19 would strike? As I said, people expected a say raise in the April-June quarter. Usually, the if not the pay commission, the annual raise is there, at least for the in the basic structure or the say inflation allowances, which are given to the government employees especially. But COVID actually beech mein aake khadde mein pair ada liya usne. So many people actually had to opt for lower EMIs because they were expecting their incomes to go up after March. Whereas it happened the reverse. They either lost their job or faced the pay cuts. So even saw them dropping to zero. So the best line would be select cautious optimism over aggression. It is good to be aggressive, but if you have a backup plan, then only you can go for it. So lesson number 8, never take a loan you can't afford to repay, because debt can be scary. I always mention the loan, the debt, or any kind of EMI should never cross 40% of your gross income. Should never cross. It should be well within that limit. It should not be even 40%. It should be lower than that. I always say ideal EMI is 15 to 20%, not beyond that, even if you have to take a loan. So manage your things well, because I, being a banker's son, I will always be against the loan. But I understand in today's time for people, they don't want to say put a burden on their parents. They would always want to go for a loan. But if they can, they want to, remember, this is the limit you have to stick. Because if you can manage loans well, you can actually manage your, say, growth as well in those aspects which are growing parallel with your clinic line. And again, loans can help us in financial emergency. But always see your repayment capacity, because otherwise, your lot of things may be at risk. And that may include your some of the precious assets. And along with that, it can build up a lot of stress, leading to, say, attracting so many problems, blood pressure, diabetes, all those things which are part of stress of anybody's life. Remember, you don't solve problems by crying. You don't solve problems by, say, taking stress. You don't solve problems by this. You only solve problems by taking a proactive step. And loans are never a proactive step, especially the high-end loans. So these are, say, currently tough times. Even till today, not many self-employed can boast of this thing, that their full OPDs, I'm talking the dentists only here, or the doctors, that their full OPDs have resumed to the pre-COVID levels. Probably they're close to 60, 70, 80%, some even 90%. Some may have got even beyond that. But no one can say it has been a consistent one as we used to have in pre-COVID times. So remember, expecting from government to do something when it is occupied with so many things is wrong, rather than carve out a path for yourself. So I always say there are few things scarier than losing your income and having debts to pay. That is actually very scary for me as well. So my dad never ever allowed me to take a loan. A couple of consumer loans which I have taken for television on the festive occasion of Diwali as well were at 0%, and all of them were paid in the PDCs first, the post-dated checks. So I normally don't do that. But the lesson in this is never overborrow and have a backup plan or a contingency or emergency plan to repay your loans on time if your normal income ceases to exist. Remember, this is your backup plan for that. So lesson number 9, anyone who is above 40, I will regard him. If he has good amount of assets, it is time to prepare your will and complete your nomination formalities. Yeah, all your assets, all your bank deposits, all your properties, all your usually mutual funds have it, stocks have it, but all other financial instruments you have, you should have a nomination at least. Not having multiple names, joint or a triplicate names, you should have a nomination, because it is a cumbersome process. If somebody accidentally passes away, yes, the fear of pandemic hasn't gone. I mentioned in the previous session, people 28, 29, 38, 39, 4 people have died in past 2 days because of COVID. So it is not a disease that is affecting the senior citizens only. So if somebody untimely, accidentally, God forbid, dies, we need to understand that family members sometimes have to fight a long battle, and it might be a say dirty battle as well. It can lead to legal disputes as well sometimes between the brothers, between the sisters, between whatever it is. So it is always better to do all those financial say formalities like nomination and will part to your all financial instruments, and so that no legal heir suffers in your absence. So diversify your investment to mitigate risks. The slide of never putting all eggs in one basket was there a few slides earlier. It was not rearranged, I'm sorry. But what it means is that you do not invest everything in mutual fund or everything in stock market or everything in property or everything in PPF or everything in government security. You need to create a balance. There should always be a hedge in that. If hedge means something that can balance out both. For example, gold was at 40,000 or so just pre-COVID. And in during COVID, in August itself or September, it almost touched 60. Now again, it is close to 50. So that means it had 33% growth, which 50% growth, which is phenomenal for any investment to have. No investment was that worthy in return manner. A few group participants asked me at that time, can we book our profits? The gold is at all-time high. So what did you buy gold for? Sir, as an investment. So then, do you have loans running? Yes, sir. So book your profits to pay off your loans so that your salary or your income from your clinic is not riddled with pressure. So that is to be done. So remember, if you have a government security or investment like a PPF at 7.5 or 8% as currently at 7.1 and a mutual fund giving you at around 12, you need to balance that out because the bottom line is to beat inflation. And yes, inflation figures might have fallen down now because of the limited number of wants we have. The vacations are not happening big time. Yes, people are still going, but not in huge numbers as they used to go pre-COVID. The malls are not having that much footfall. Multiplexes are definitely closed. OTT platform is booming. So the wants have reduced considerably. So I consider the practical inflation might be less. But if I speak in normal times, the inflation figures are close to whatever the government says. They're always close to 10%. The government figures might be 4, 5, 6. But what I mean by inflation here is that your cost of living actually increases by 10% every year. If, again, COVID times discounted, if you go back to last December 2019, supposing there was no COVID, and look at your expenses of December 2020, presuming it is all normal, you will find that if your cost of living then was 50,000, now it would be approximately 55,000. So what does that mean? The cost of living has increased by 10,000. Where will that 10% come from? Not 10,000, sorry, 10%. So where will that 10% come from? That will come from your investment. Whatever you are growing in practice, growing in your, say, market or financial instruments or your investments, that is kind of your passive income, which is compensating for the inflation part. So you need to beat the inflation. The bottom line aim is always and should always be to beat the inflation. Anything like 8 and 12 will be, say, hedged by something like a gold, so that you can actually say have a growth of more than 10%. It does not mean that you put everything in gold or put everything in mutual fund. You need to diversify. You need to put all things and not put all things in one basket. As I mentioned, gold has given good returns. So spread your investment so that even if somebody, some asset class faces a drop, you can vary your things accordingly. So equally important is that you understand your risk appetite. Somebody may be earning high but has a low risk appetite. Hota hai meri kamai chahe 2 lakh a mahina ki, let's suppose, but mere ko 10,000 se zyada mera risk nahi hai. Agar 10,000 doob jayega, no problem. But if it is beyond that, I'll have a heart attack or I have a heartache at least. So somebody earning 1 lakh will say, I can put in 30,000 of my money in risk. Say I'm not averse to risk, but I can put in 1/3 of my money, 30,000, in that. So if that grows, it'll give me 60 in short time. But if not, the 30,000 is gone. I don't feel a, say, pinch in my body. So that is the way you decide your risk appetite. And that is dependent upon your family circle around you as well. How many kids you have? How many dependents you have? How much life expenses are there? How much is your average income? What are your other liabilities? What are your loans to be paid for? All the things you need to realize, actually. It has to be in a cycle format. So if you have a higher dependent or a higher liabilities in your kitty, you will automatically have a low risk appetite. So don't be then unrealistic about investments. Remember, it is your money only. It is very hard earned. Sara din patients se lad lad ke jhagda karke paise kamate hain. Many of us, not all of us at least, but many of us. So we need to remember that if that money is so hard earned, why do we literally need to throw it away in that regard? So do not discontinue essential investments. The government security should be there. My father taught me one thing. Tum jis mein marzi invest karo. Before 5th April, your 1.5 lakh should go in PPF. And it should continue to do so till you can do it. So I'm into 22nd year of my PPF. It was 15 year plus 5 year. It is renewed for the third time now. So, the second time now in its third cycle. So, I'm still putting in 1.5 lakhs because I'm trying to earn the maximum through the compounding. If I put in the whole, you can choose to put in different, different portions or different, parts. But I do it in one go. And that is the reason I advise all of you to do as well. So always it is the bottom line is always is if you are looking to have a long-term return, the longer you will stay invested, the better are your chances to fetch desired return. So if you are face any problem to diversify, to balance your portfolio, always take the help of a qualified financial advisor. Never decide yourself unless you are expert in that. And it is never a hit and trial thing. Then I always mention about the goals part in a different manner when I take the wealth creation session, and all those sessions are on YouTube. But then we need to understand that we need to invest as per our goals. I give the example, somebody graduated with me, probably married earlier than me, probably started his clinic earlier than me, maybe had kids earlier than me. I have kids aged almost 14 and 4 now. So he might be having kids 18 and 15 in age. So his goals might be different. His 18-year-old would be gone to college or almost ready to go to college. The 15-year-old would be going to college in 3 years' time. So he cannot block his money for longer period. In my case, one of my kids, of course, not an intentional choice, but if the one kid is about 14 years, I need to make sure that if I have funds today and want to invest in her name, I will never go for a long-term investment. I'll keep it so that I need the funds around 17 and a half or 18 or so till the kid is major and will go in for higher education. For the younger one, I can block that money for 14 years or so. Because this is the difference how you emphasize and set your goals. For a youngster who's just started out, he's a 27, 28 year old. What are his imminent goals? His goals might be a new clinic for himself and marriage. Both can happen simultaneously or both can happen one after the other, but both are to happen in the next 1 to 2 years maximum. Then once you're married, what is your next goal? Expansion of clinic maybe along with and bringing the first child into the family. 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, whatever the plan of the couple is. Then the next big goal is sending the first child to big school, not the play school, but the big school. Then if the couple wishes to bringing a second child into the family. So this way is you set your goals for 3 to 4 to 5 years. And then the ultimate goal, kids' education. Of course, you can't plan for everything in life, but you still need to plan for certain things in your life. You need to understand this thing. And that is where the investors are ignorant about it. Tune kisme paisa lagaya, chal mera bhi laga de usme. That is the way we invest. We don't give it a thought. What is our profession? We are doctors, we are dentists. What we do? We diagnose, make a treatment plan, think over it, then convey to the patient. Ye nahi karenge, isse ye ho jayega. Patient has some pre-planned Google say suggested plan is in his or her mind. We suggest, nahi ye karoge to ye ho jayega. The patient agrees to us. So why don't we follow the same diagnosis and treatment planning exercise when it comes to finance? Why do we prefer over-the-counter products when it comes to finance? So remember, if you have invested just for the sake of finance, we all saw people panicked in March and sold it off. Don't do that. Then lesson number 12, don't invest in equity for short-term. Equity is always for long-term investment because equity is one volatile investment which is going to go up and down continuously. it is an extension of the previous point only. So people lost money in March and booked losses, and their temporary losses became their permanent ones. But if they had aimed for a longer period and kept just the patience of 9 months, the market is at its all-time high. What else do you want in the same calendar year? And if people still say COVID is bad, it is a personal choice. It is a personal decision because they were impatient. So if your goal is minimum 5 to 6 years away, invest in equities. Otherwise, invest in liquid funds, debt funds, whatever you can use. Again, bank deposits does not understand for fixed deposits. It can be in a high earning saving bank account as well. Then build alternate or passive source of income. COVID actually made this thing also necessary. Never take life for granted, because we usually do. And do not want to move out of our comfort zone. We need to understand that an alternate source of income is always handy. For us, usually the alternate source of income is compounding. So many people got laid off from their jobs with the outbreak of virus. But then passive income like a rental income or a producing an online content. When I first came to know that a YouTuber is also a profession some years back, I was seriously shocked that a YouTuber, someone making YouTube videos, is earning money and earning big money. It was a shock for me a few years back. But then freelancing, producing online content, it is all part of the profession. And this is a free world. You have technology at your disposal and internet connections at damn cheap prices. So why not utilize it to grow in life? And otherwise, for dentists, those who have built up a good portfolio, I always say compounding is your passive income or is your secondary income. If you have good corpus flown in, that money which you're earning out of that is your passive income. So lesson number 14, do not make rash financial decisions, rather make informed ones. You all have had nail-biting 12 months. And it is, say, everything, as I said, social, economic, political, many things have changed. The cyclones are happening, the lockdowns are happening, and so many other things happening. The political condition is not very stable was not very stable in US as well. So all those things will continue to happen. Nobody can predict what will happen in 2021. But it is always better not to get impatient. People who got impatient were the ones who actually had locked all money in equity. And when they saw the market crashing, they said, jitna milta utna nikal lo. That was the advice some of the advisors also give sometimes. And then you know what are the results. So be very vigilant. Avoid any Ponzi schemes, any dubious offers which can affect financial status. And global stock markets, when they go downhill because of any other reasons, Indian stock markets will follow them suit many a times. So that is the reason the foreign investors have invested at an all-time high in Indian markets. Yes, when they exit Indian markets, whenever they do, maybe in months, maybe in years, in weeks, that is for them to know, then the market will surely go down and the asset class will go down. But remember, there is no limit to stock exchange. It was 4,000 at the time of Herschel Mehta in 1992. It'll go up. It'll keep on growing. In 10 years time, we might see it the Sensex at 80,000 or 1 lakh. So it'll grow only. It'll keep on growing. Keep going down, keep going up. That thing is going to happen always. But you need to know that where you need the money and where what is the time to book the profits. That is for you to understand. If you keep on putting your money continuously and no time for withdrawal, then you need to understand that there has to be a certain limit according to that. So lesson number 15, a very vital one. We can really save more than what we think. Because of the shutdown, we were all at home. We knew. Cinemas closed, theaters, concerts called off, local pubs were shut down. All the wants, all the ways to throw our money, I will use that word, throw our money, were actually, say, closed. So how much money we saved when we were at our tightest restrictions, we all know that. We actually knew that we didn't need much money to, say, survive in our life. Yes, people had Maggie parties, pizza parties even in lockdown, but that's fine. Even they were not expensive parties. Then lesson number 16, Most of the valuable lessons are always available in history. As I said, always never look at the past. If you want to grow in life, you have to get rid of the past. Just take lessons from the past. Never forget those things, but don't keep on lingering those things. Don't keep on your present and future be spoiled because of that. So the Great Depression in the world happened in 1929. The market ultimately did revive. As I said, the stock market will revive. It will keep on going up. So, but the speculators were who may make speculations or say make predictions in the market. They were actually say taken out of the question by the Great Depression. So it actually taught humanity about great debts as well. Banks revised their policies, their interest rates. The markets remained bullish for more than a decade. So the bears wonder where is our future in today's markets. Don't worry, their time will also come. So the policy changes because of the earlier pandemics, everyone will have a few lessons from that. And trust me, COVID-19 is also going the same way. So for us, if you want to have best financial lesson, everything is there in our past. It all actually holds the secrets to our future, as they say. So lastly, but not the least in any way, lesson number 17, do not try to time the market. You cannot actually gauge how much volatility will be there, when it will fall, when it will go up. People can make a lot of speculations and predictions, but not necessarily all will get true. If all were true, everybody would be every prediction guy on the news channels, on the CNBC or the Z Business or similar channels would be a billionaire. So not all of them are. So you need to understand that. If predicting stock market was that easy, astrologers could make hay while the sun shines. So timing the market may not be worth the risk, can be hazardous also sometimes. So I hope I have not been preachy enough and not crossed the deadline. So the carry home gyan as usual at the end of my presentations. 2020 has taught us a hard financial lesson. So better control your finances and continue to build your fund for your future. So as we say ki doctor family mein hona chahiye kyunki medical cheeze jo hoti hai na to pata honi chahiye sabko. Similarly, financial guardian in the family jo financial planning ke nuts and bolts ko understand karta hai, you need to understand that. So become a financial guardian for your family. My dream, which I have been nurturing for a few years. But after seeing the disappointing response from all the dentists around me, I'm shelving it for a while. That is the reason I'm not, renewed the paid group for 2021. I have a few personal goals to meet. So yes, my dream was there to say financial literacy for every dentist in India. Unfortunately, it has reached nowhere. Yes, I'm disappointed, but not totally out of it. Maybe I'll take it up at a later version. I'll keep doing whatever I can in my limited capacity to educate dentists. My free groups will continue. Of course, the paid group is not being renewed for 2021. So free groups will continue until the time I can. And if you, as I mentioned in the previous practice management session, if you continue to not open the groups, you know what you are missing out. I'm not missing out on anything. So people who are abusing WhatsApp as a mode of communication, they only know what they are missing out on. So the take homes always should be learning knowledge, skills, experience, ability, growth, competence, and training from any epidemic, pandemic, endemic, whatever, or any kind of disaster that happens around us. So if we can't learn from this pandemic, we all know, as I said, it'll occur after 100 years. No one of us of our generation who are dentists will be alive to foresee that. God forbid that happens even for our future generations. I don't wish so. So still time to go if you want to learn. All the best for that. So the next session happens for the paid group tomorrow, 7:30 in practice management. And the last session for paid group also happens on 29th at 7:30. That'll be it for the paid group members as well for this year. Yes, they'll have a lot of literaries fun on 31st, which I'll be doing. So thank you so much for your patience on a Sunday evening till late. I hope I have stuck to my 45 to 60 minute time. Yes, I have 57 minutes into the presentation. So this is my YouTube channel. If you want to watch videos on practice management, medical legal ethics and finance, this is the channel you need to subscribe. Of course, this is, I have very clearly segregated. I'm very clear about my goals. I've very clearly segregated that this channel is for dentists only. It is not for my patients. So please send me your valuable feedback in your group, wherever you can, or on my number. Bookers and Brickbats would be both welcome in equal measure. This is the least I can do for my profession. So I'm giving it back in whatever way I can. So thank you so much. And I stop my share for your questions or queries if there are any. Okay, let me just check the messages. Okay, Dr. Dheeraj, sir, kindly explain what should be, let me just unmute all of you as well. Sorry, you can unmute yourself as well if you want to ask once I answer the chat questions. So kindly explain what should be asset allocation for medium dental for short and long-term care. See, the simple asset allocation in India, we follow the age-old formula. The 100 minus your age should be in equity. That is the standard formula followed all over the world. But for Indian conditions to be on the safer side, we say if a 30-year-old has to invest 70% in equity, 100 minus his age, it would be too much asking for that. To be on the safer side, we always say in Indian conditions, 80 minus your age is the safest bet to go. If you're young, you have lesser liabilities, lesser responsibilities. You can put in a lot of amount in your equity. In that sense, as you grow older in your middle age, 40s, you will have more responsibilities, more goals to meet in coming times. So you need to take care accordingly. Dr. Amit asks, which fund is good for retirement funds for the duration of 15 years? Dr. Amit, there are so many plans available. If you want to build a retirement fund, the number one option should be NPS for you. If we go back to the COVID times, of course, these are also COVID times going on. But historically, we have been seeing ELSS or equity mutual funds are the number one in return in terms of returns. NPS was number two. But when the stock markets crashed 40%, NPS became number one. So your number one thing should be to put in NPS. And there is no upper limit. Of course, upper limit is 20% of your gross income, which you can put in NPS. But a minimum of 50,000 is desirable every year. For tax saving purpose also, for growing also. So the first, rather than going in for a private fund, I'll first advise you to go in for NPS where you can actually save on your tax also. Then think of the other avenues. When you can put in a lot of fund and currently also NPS is almost say joint number one in terms of return. So don't look out for funds first. First look at NPS and then look out for, if you have money to spare, then look at the funds for that. Dr. Ajayat, what's your advice for charge reduction for treatments according of lower financial conditions? So I mentioned in the previous session, it was a question by Dr. Ravi in that session. So you don't need to actually reduce your charges. Yes, empathy, compassion is something else. You really don't need to understand that whatever you want to charge, especially in these COVID times when your charges based on protocols, when they have risen on a while, and you need to take care of those things as well. So if your cost has increased, how can you charge low? That is a simple thing. How can you drop your revenue? I have given a formula to raise your treatment charges. In that, I've added the increased treatment charges as well, where you are going to do that. And if you're having a less income as well, you're taking lesser charges, higher cost, imagine where you'll end up with. You need to understand that you don't need to lower charges. I gave you the GST example. Things are selling. People are buying. Jab bura time aata, sab sunate hain. Jab achha aata, koi nahi bolta. Complain karne wale karte rahenge. Lekin people are earning. People are spending these days. Everything has almost revived now. But still people feel nahi abhi manda chala. They want to live in that false security mentally themselves. So it is up to them. Prarthi, thank you. Dr. Rakesh, thank you. Dr. Amitabh, what are index? What about index funds? Index funds are, cheap and effective options to beat the market. You can, again, first do the basics right. I always say, complete your tax saving part, then go for wealth creation part. And these are the things you need to understand, that once you have a hold of many things, then you adventure into other things. There might be many things lucrative to you, but it is not always going to be beneficial for all of us. What works for me might not work for you, and vice versa. What works for you might not work for me as well. So we need to understand the unique. Just because somebody else is earning in that, we don't need to go in for that. As for your question, index funds are good, but yes, you need to be very careful about them. Okay, Dr. Ajay, thank you. Yes, any more questions? I finished the chat questions. So any more questions, you can unmute yourself and ask. So, thank you, Dr. Mahesh.
Hello, can you elaborate on some of the liquid fund?
So what is the goal? The first thing I always ask whenever somebody asks me what the fund is, what is the goal?
See, I didn't get you what exactly you want to mean.
Why do you need to invest in the liquid fund?
I want to invest in liquid fund because I want some money after 6 months again.
What returns do you expect in a liquid fund?
Say around 7 to 8%.
Okay, and what is the amount you want to put in over there?
I want to put around 8 lakhs.
Why don't you put that amount? Let's suppose that is an emergency fund. Why don't you put that amount in a high earning savings account?
But which bank is giving more savings?
IDFC is giving you 7%.
Which?
IDFC First.
Okay, I'll put it in that.
It is giving you 7%. Then 7 to 8 is not, you can't get 7 to 8 in liquid fund these days. Then there will be a taxation of 15% on that.
Yes, right.
Your returns would be close to 5, 5.5 only.
Okay.
The amount and the goal and the purpose is very important. It is not always that you just blindly invest in any investment. Because again, liquid funds, debt funds are all meant for short purpose. But to define that purpose, the taxation aspect, you need to be very clear on that.
Okay, thank you.
Any more questions, please?
Hello, good evening, sir.
Dr. Dheeran.
Yes. Sir, you should also explain and take some seminar.
Dheeran, your voice is cracking up.
Hello?
Yeah.
So you should also explain or take some Zoom meeting on stocks also, because we want to learn something on stock market also.
There are more than 1,300 people in the group and only 25 are attending. The maximum attendance was 38. I took these sessions as a trial purpose. This is the 18th session. I'll be taking 2 more.
So that will always be there.
Always be there, but then I also have priorities in my life as well. I also have priorities in my life. That is the reason I'm very disappointed at the response. I've been giving a lot of things free of cost. Probably they are not being valued that. So I need to move on also. I've learned a lesson as well from the COVID year. So I'm also moving on to my own desired things in life. So if there was a plan in the past to take up a similar session by Endo Haveli guys, when I took up a session of August on my dad's birthday. So they wanted, Dr. Sanket wanted me to take a similar session on stocks. So maybe if there is a tie-up in future, I'll take up something on that, but no problem in that. So Dr. Amit asks, sir, for income tax, it should be deposit one time or SIP better in ELSS? See, for income tax, I already mentioned, you should definitely complete your ATC on before the 1st April in your PPF. So your ATC is covered. So whatever next you do in ELSS is purely dependent on you. Obviously, for the lump sum, you can't properly time the market. You might say invest in an ELSS and the market crashes the next day. And it takes about 6 months to recover. So after 6 months, you are at the same starting point. In the SIP, the rupee cost averaging is there and you can take advantage of the market highs and the lows. So in that regard, the tax is out of the equation. So I always advise at least go in for the government thing and complete your ATC, your NPS, your other medical part. Of course, those things don't have to be related to the 5th April. Only the government thing is to be there for the ATC. That should be completed before that time. So that is taken out of the equation. And then let's suppose the market, you are doing a SIP mode, the market crashes and it continues to for some time, what you can do is top up your SIP. You can add further amount to your SIP so that you can buy more units at a decreased price. So that is the way you can take advantage of the fallen market as well. You buy more units, and when the market goes up, you can earn in that situation. Your fund value goes up. So that is the way you can time it. It is not the time to actually buy lump sum. I am rather saying it is the time to book the profit. That means you actually, if you have been holding certain things for 4, 5, 6 years, you need to actually sell them. That is what I'm saying by booking profits.
Okay.
Any link or guidance for HUF creation? HUF is actually Hindu Undivided Family. It is a option available to all the religions, Buddhists, Jains, Sikhs, Christians, and Hindus, of course, but not to Muslims because they have their separate law for that purpose. So everyone can create a, with minimum 4 members are required, you can create a HUF. In this, HUF becomes a separate entity. So you actually say earn for 4 and save or take tax deduction for 5. So HUF has its own PAN and it files return on behalf of its members. And the bad or the sad murmurs or news is that maybe this budget 2021, HUF might be done away with. Will you recommend, Dr. Vinay asked, will you recommend one to deposit 1.5 to PPF even when the 6 interest rate dropped to 6.8 and stocks, mutual funds to give more returns? Will you recommend to reduce the PPF part? See, if you are going only for tax saving strictly, you can divide your investments as per your discretion. 1/3, 2/3, 1/2, any one you wish. But if you are actually, say, going for wealth creation part, you're investing beyond 1.5 lakhs, that 1.5 should go in for PPF irrespective of the percentage. If that is going down, that has to do with inflation. Remember, still you are not splurging on your wants. Most of us are not spending ridiculous money on our things which we desire or which we throw away, which we were doing pre-COVID. Yes, EMI is a part, which we have indulged in that for that. But we are not going to multiplexes. We are not dining out every other day. We are not going for long vacations. We are not going to especially foreign vacations. So all that money is being saved, which will effectively affect the inflation part. And once the inflation is down, you actually need lesser money. So then the government will pay only what it is getting from you. Remember that. So those interest rates have to be in sync with that. So not an issue with that. If that those interest rates are going down, the inflation is also going down. So if I'm saying you have to earn around 10% to beat the inflation, next year maybe you need to need 8% to beat the inflation in that regard. So remember, all those things work in unison only. Dr. Raghu Ganesh asks, in the NPS, there are choices of amount of annuity and lump sum. Can you please explain which would be better and which is the selected as LIC, ICA, pension fund? Very confusing. Preferably choose HDFC or ICI, or the third choice would be SBI. Yes, there is not much of difference, but these are the funds which are giving good returns. In that, the annuity option to purchase is given at the time of retirement when you are availing the money, not at today's time. At the age of 60, if you are renewing, you can renew even up to 70. You can continue to pay from 60 to 70, but not beyond 70. So HDFC, ICA, and SBI in that order, maybe followed by Birla Sun Life, and then others, UTI, Kotak, and LIC. All those. There are 7 options. So I've named all 7 in that order. So you need, you can put in lump sum, you can put in monthly, but minimum 1,000 is required every year. So all funds are goal-based investments. So right now, no profit booked now in MF. That's perfectly fine, Dr. Amit. That is not an issue. If your funds are not giving, if your funds are giving you good returns, if they're based on certain goals, you can say, let them grow. They'll always grow, definitely. So not an issue in that. But if you have a need coming up in 6 months, if you have a goal coming up in 6 months, then I will advise you to book at least partial profit. If not, if it is beyond 1 year or 1.5 year, then stay invested.
Sir, most of the funds are in say up to 7 years to 10 years goal based.
Then stay invested.
And right now the percent of growth is 25% growth.
Then stay invested. Then stay invested.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Sumit. Any more questions or we wind up for the day? A lot of plans for this Sunday because it was the last Sunday before the new year. A lot of plans. Luckily, I completed 90% of my tasks today. Started very early at 4:45 today, but I'm able to almost complete 90%. So I'm happy with that. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Prayan. Please do post your feedback in the WhatsApp group as well. At least if it can wake up some from the slumber, I'll be very happy. Okay. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Dr. Vinay. If there are any, please post in the group. I'll answer whenever there is convenient time for that. Thank you. Have a good night. Have a Monday, last Monday of the year without the Monday blues. I hope you all have a safe holiday season and a very happy new year. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.